All right. So why would you need a tool like FindEth? Well, some wallets behave in unexpected ways. So a Ledger wallet, I've got my Ledger connected right now, actually, it's actually mentioned in the source code for FindEth, and we'll see it happening later, in that the ETH application on Ledger, that's when you select the ETH application, only supports these two derivation paths, or things starting with these two derivation paths here. So on Ethereum, I mean on Ledger, you essentially have different apps that you install on the device for all these different things. In a sense, Ledger's trying to protect you from yourself, but the problem is that, for example, if I'm here on my MyEtherWallet and say I clicked on that one first, just the default, I've got an address that starts there, and then I click down here on Music Coin, you'll notice nothing changes because it's not one of the selected paths that the Ledger supports. Now, the issue arises in that if I happen to have clicked on this one first and then clicked back on Music Coin, it's basically just sticks with whatever it was last. So the issue there is that if you had a Ledger and that supported one of these different derivation paths, one of these, only these four really, and then you clicked on to say a different one, so like Ledger ETC, the one you clicked on beforehand is what's going to decide which addresses show up here. So it, again, there are just plenty of ways that you could sort of forget which derivation path you'd used. If you've got any other questions, certainly just leave a reply in the comments. If this has been useful to you, subscribe. I'm hoping to just continue to put some regular material together that just outlines some of the different tools and things that can help folk to learn, to recover stuff if they've lost it, and to stay safe.